Morning, guys. Good morning to you all. Good morning, my subscribers. Thank you very much for support of my channel. Today we are talking about narcissistic personality disorder. Why really about narcissistic? Really, I made presentation for you about antisocial personality disorder, borderline, schizotypal personality disorder, and finally, I decided to make final presentation about narcissistic personality disorder, and after that, go for schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is my favorite topic. I am a psychiatrist with wide experience. All my life I am a psychiatrist, and exactly schizophrenia still number one for everyone who is in psychiatry. I am a member of too many psychiatric and psychological association, and really a few days ago I got invitation from one of my friends from Pakistan to participate in Pakistan webinar about narcissistic personality disorder, and I decided to make video about narcissistic personality disorder and explain my position, my experience about narcissistic personality disorder, symptoms of narcissistic personality disorder, how to help somebody and how to survive in our difficult time in society with symptoms of narcissistic personality disorder. A little bit back in history, at least you must remember that narcissistic personality disorder belonging cluster B. When I did presentation for you about personality disorder, group of personality cluster A, cluster B, and cluster C, I explained that we have three cluster A, four cluster B, and three in cluster C. And narcissistic personality disorder belonging group B. It's very common now, and really exactly more. It's really male personality disorder, narcissistic personality disorder, because statistically more men compared with women. And first person who described personality disorder, narcissistic personality, was psychoanalyst. It was Robert Walder in 1925. And 1965, Heath Cohut, he really described this condition as a narcissistic personality disorder. Narcissistic personality disorder is all termin, just the same, megalomania. Yeah, but now, according to DSM-5 classification, we are using this condition as a as a narcissistic personality disorder. What it means? It's one of several types of personality disorder. Is mental condition in which people have, I'm reading from DSM-5 classification, in which people have an inflated sense of their own importance, a deep need for excessive attention and admiration, and they have troubled relationship and lack of empathy for others. This one is main symptom of narcissistic personality disorder. Really, we have 10 symptoms, and I'm going to talk. And if you can check up yourself, if you have minimum 5 from this group, then symptom of narcissistic personality disorder, or your friends, or member of family, somebody has this symptom, you must be very careful, take into consideration, and go yourself to see one of specialists, counselor, psychologist, or psychiatrist, or send your close relative for assessment. And exactly this long life illness, and if, for example, somebody at right time did not go to see specialist, after next time it can come serious complication, and it affect your relationship, private relationship, personal relationship, your work, school, and financial affair. Okay, coming to symptom. Now I want to explain for you about symptom of narcissistic personality disorder. Like I explained, main, it's 10 symptom. Number one, it's everyone who is suffering from narcissistic personality disorder, they have an exaggerated sense of self-importance. Self-importance. This one usually it's number one for narcissistic personality disorder. This person really from young age, mostly from teenager, believes that he is special. He is very self-important without any background, without anything else. Because if you are, for example, king, and you have really evidence of speciality, exactly, you can be self-important, you know. But if you're ordinary person, without proper background, you did not get anything else in your life, but you believe that you very self-important person. This one, in this situation, exactly, you must be very careful. Number two, expect to recognize as superior even without achievement, without any achievements. But he likes to be recognized as superior without any achievements. This one, just the same, it's very important. Be preoccupied with fantasy about success, about power, about brilliance, beauty, or perfect mate. This one, fantasy in psychiatry, sometimes we explain it's over idea of grandiosity. We have delusion of grandiose with lack of insight, false belief. But in this situation, it's preoccupied, it's over idea, over grandiose idea about success, about power, about brilliance, about beauty, and something else. Belief that he is special, he is superior, and can be associated with equally special people. Why this type of people? They prefer to communicate with somebody else, you know, who is rich, who is famous, and ABCD, because these people falsely believe it's, oh, you see, it's grandiose idea. It's not really delusion, because for delusion we need ABCD, but this over idea, preoccupation. Rule breaking. What it means? These people, they can't follow instructions. They can't follow rule because they believe they are special. Everyone respect, everyone must admire, and ABCD. Why, for example, they can't stay a long queue when it's traffic, they try to speed, they try to overtake, and ABCD. These people usually rule breaking, you know, rule breaking. They can use one of symptoms charming. These people, they know how to use charm, you know, how to use this charm for monitoring of people. These two connections, charming, they try to turn on the charm to people. And people usually, if I can see firstly this person who try to be perfectionist, who believes that he is best one, he is talentless, he is ABCD. Really, I can see, and really, for example, I can say, this guy is looking, is well-looking guy, he is something special, you know. They can be very charm, and they using this, they can turn on the charm of people for manipulating of these people. Why it would be dangerous? Charming and manipulation usually together. Usually together. Desire for control. They like to keep all member of family or situation or member of workma under control. They try to be in charge of everything. They try to be in center of company, of party, of anything else. And desire for control. They like to keep under control situation. Conversation hogger. Just the same, it's very important stuff. Conversation hogger. If, for example, you have conversation and coming person with narcissistic personality disorder, everything is changed. He is in center of company, he is in center of conversation, and really he's leader of conversation, he's in charge of conversation. This one's typical, just the same. And blame. Usually, like I explained, they're keeping under control situation, but if something it's not successful, more easy explanation, you know, this type of people blame it everyone. Everyone is guilty in this situation. Why we did not get success in this company or something else, but not himself. Never ever he can be guilty. Everyone is guilty. He blame everyone, but not himself. This one, like I explained for you, it's 10 symptoms and exactly lack of empathy, like I explained to you, it's really was since beginning, it's lacking empathy. This type of person, they stay emotionally flat, and despite charm, despite a little bit mannerism, you know, despite perfectionism usually lack empathy. They can be married ABCD, but they never show. But for example, you got serious problem, you got bad experience somewhere. They can talk with you, but never ever can show for you, you see, empathy. Doesn't matter who are you, wife or mom or sister or somebody. Lacking empathy. Just the same, it's very typical for narcissistic personality disorder. Now you can see 10 main symptoms of narcissistic personality disorder. Now you know, if you have close member of family or if you have friends who is suffering from it, mostly exactly it's men, 70%. Now you know that this guy, your friend or your brother or your husband, suffering from narcissistic personality disorder. And in this situation, like I explained, everyone, they need admire, you know, they need attention. And if they can't get proper attention or proper admire, they can suddenly change behavior and became irritable, angry, they can develop depression and ABCD. Why better? Plus, sometimes in my practice, I had cases with parasuicide when they tried to commit suicide because they were very disappointed. An explanation, I am special doctor, you know, I am special, I am brilliant doctor, you know, but not any achievement, absolutely not any achievement in background. I am special doctor, but why nobody can understand me? Why nobody can respect me, especially my close member of family, my wife, my sister, and my mom, you see. This one is coming very disappointment for this type of narcissistic personality, why they can develop depression, any type of anxiety disorder, plus serious depression with suicidal ideation. Up to now, really, is not known the cause of narcissistic, that's all personality disorder, we don't know cause. We can suggest about environment, we can suggest about genetics, we can suggest about neurobiology, this combination, yeah, it can happen. But we don't know exactly number one reason why somebody can develop narcissistic personality, somebody can't develop. No, risk factor just the same, too many theories, too many suggestions, especially from scientists, you know, from psychologists, mostly of beliefs that exactly it can start from family. Sometimes they say it's, childhood, they suggested, especially sexual abuse. Just the same, we are coming back, according to Freud, we are coming back to sexual relationship. Sexual abuse, just the same, can affect condition and it can really push for developing on narcissistic personality disorder. Patterning style, just the same, overprotective or neglected, just the same may have an impact, you know, everything can. Genes also, exactly, if in your family you had somebody who was suffering from any type of personality disorder or serious mental illness, as a schizophrenia, exactly, risky to get narcissistic personality disorder. Complication of narcissistic personality disorder can be, exactly, it's affected if, for example, you are suffering from narcissistic personality disorder 20 years and never went to see counselor, psychologist or psychiatrist, it's coming relationship difficulty, it's coming problem at work or for young one at school or at university, it's coming depression or anxiety, it's coming physical health problem, drug or alcohol misuse, and suicidal thought or behavior. Especially in my private practice and my forensic practice, I had really patients who were suffering from narcissistic personality disorder and plus alcohol misuse or drug misuse, you know, to be perfect, you know, to be like in charge of company, in charge of conversation, in charge of party, you need something stimulant, you know, and sometimes they're using any type of drug, not for extension, for psychostimulation, you know, and they're using any type of drugs, especially to be a little bit high, you see, to be in special condition. Prevention just the same. I can't explain for you about prevention because we don't know cause of personality narcissistic personality disorder. At least number one, everyone who has this problem must get treatment as soon as possible. As soon as possible, you know. Participate in family therapy, for example, how to communicate and how to cope with people who are suffering from this condition. And now we are coming to treatment of narcissistic personality disorder. Now you know symptoms. Like I explained, I met too many in my private practice because mostly of people who are suffering from narcissistic personality disorder, they believe they are normal. Но why they believe? Because you see, firstly, they believe they are special, and they must communicate only in special environment with special people. They are gifted, and ABCD, they are perfectionist. And in this situation, they believe it's normal life, it's normal condition. They don't need any help. More easy, you know. And only an environment, only people around, like member of family, close friends, or wife. Or some colleague, for example, from work, you can see symptom and explain that my brother, my father, my husband, you need help from counselor, psychologist, and psychiatrist. At right time, go to see. Mostly of it's talk therapy. Exactly, it's psychotherapy and talk therapy. Medication we are using very, very rare. Only if it's coming complication as a severe depression with suicidal, we are using antidepressant, and sometimes maybe mood stabilizer if it's necessary, if behavior became a little bit over with over fantasy, grandiose, and ABCD. Mostly we are using talk therapy and psychotherapy. Exactly, we are using three types of therapy. It's cognitive therapy, cognitive analytic therapy, and functional analytical therapy. Everything is under care of psychologist, psychotherapist, and at least it can help person who is suffering from narcissistic personality disorder to cope in society, to stay with family, with wife and ABCD, maybe not 100% recovering, but at least it can help to be socially adapted. It's very important because main trouble for this type of people, it's social dysfunction. And very interesting program as a self-help strategy we are using in each country, especially very popularly here in United States. Just the same, my friends from Germany and from UK, I had discussion before to do this presentation. They explained for me just the same in Germany and UK, they are using this self-help strategy. What it means? It's a special like step to be healthy and prevent more serious condition. It's practice self-care. What does it mean, practice self-care? To sleep properly, because it's very important for any type of people, for any type of mental disorder, for everyone is important to sleep properly, minimum 7 hours. Physical exercise, healthy food. This one is practice self-care. Care to look after. Avoid exactly alcohol because unfortunately people who are suffering from narcissistic, you see, like it's comorbidity, together with substance abuse or alcohol misuse. In this situation, avoid any type of alcohol because it can provoke more serious condition. Exactly, it's engage in effective stress management. And now United States and now in UK, they practice like special to keep your diary about your emotional condition. At least 2 times a day, morning and evening, writing everything about your emotional condition. How do you feel today? What was happened? And ABC describe situation, you know. And after that, analyze. Engage in effective stress management, exactly this one, it's very important, positive stress, not negative stress, positive stress. And like I explained for you before, usually we try to give advice for this type of patient, change environment, go to somewhere, stay in touch with reality, stay with mother nature. It can help everyone, like it was happened, for example, we decided with all members of my family suddenly change environment and go to Pacific Ocean. Enough sometimes, few nights, few days for to improve your emotional condition, to improve your physical, especially swimming, especially walking, you know, it's very, 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 including change environment, because if you stay in the same environment, it's affected everyone. Why better to change environment and to be close with Mother Nature? It doesn't matter, it's Pacific Ocean, it's mountains, or it's forest, everything can help you. Plus family therapy. Do you remember I had discussion? This one just the same. Better member if, for example, you have your brother, for example, or you have your husband who is suffering from narcissistic personality disorder. Exactly, better go for family therapy and especially to understand how to cope with this condition. You can't change him. You can help him for social adaptation, for private relationship to be better. But exactly you, he can't be 100% mentally stable. And very important, close member of family to understand condition of your husband, of your brother, of your father, and explanation for everyone in family therapy how to cope with this situation. Not fighting, not ABCD. How at right time take your husband or your brother who is suffering from this type of personality disorder to any type of treatment, to counselor, to psychologist, or to psychiatrist. Okay, guys, for today that's all. I hope my presentation helped you. Now you understand what it's mean narcissistic personality disorder. Now it's more common than before. Too many people suffering from, especially men, like I said, from narcissistic personality disorder. And it's very important to know symptom of this disorder. At right, take your close member of family or your husband or somebody or friend, take for assessment, for help, and to prevent of serious complication. Thank you very much. Dr. Posco together with you. I love you, my dear subscriber. Watch my video.